One day she saw them coming into the garden where the flowers live. They found the colors beautiful and they discovered the sweet smell that the flowers held. So they stamped upon and tore apart the garden. Just because, they said, those flowers, they were asking for it. There is nothing left but drippings of power and a consummate wreck of tenderness. I want to know, is this what you call only natural?
Signs of maturity is the ability to rise to the point of self-criticism. Some of us have become cynical and disillusioned. Some have so conditioned themselves to the system of segregation that they have lost that creative something called initiative. Many of us live above our means, spend money on non-essentials and frivolities, and fail to give to serious causes, organizations, and educational institutions that so desperately need funds. Therefore, there is a pressing need to develop a positive program through which these standards can be improved. There is no easy way to create a world where men and women can live together, where each has his own job and house, and where children receive as much education as their minds can absorb. But if such a world is created in our lifetime, it will be done by people of goodwill. It will be done through massive protest and by rejecting the racism, materialism, and violence that has characterized Western civilization, and especially by working toward a world of brotherhood, cooperation, and peace.
Thank you.
love must be at the forefront of our movement if it's to be a successful movement. And when we speak of love, we speak of understanding, goodwill toward all men. In struggling for human dignity, we must not succumb to the temptation of becoming bitter or indulging in hate campaigns. We have learned through the grim realities of life and history that hate and violence solve nothing. At the end, it is only destructive for everybody. Revolt against what I often call a myth of time. There are those who say wait for time and time will solve the problem. The people who argue this do not themselves realize that time is neutral, that it can be used constructively or destructively. This movement is based on hope, but before the victory is won, some will lose jobs, some will be called communists and reds merely because they believe in brotherhood. Some will be dismissed as dangerous rabble-rousers and agitators merely because they're standing up for what is right. But we shall overcome.
Thank you.
are some things in our social system to which all of us ought to be maladjusted. I never intend to adjust myself to the viciousness of mob rule. I never intend to adjust myself to the evils of segregation and the crippling effects of discrimination. I never intend to adjust myself to the inequalities of an economic system which takes necessities from the masses to give luxuries to the classes. I never intend to become adjusted to the madness of militarism and the self-defeating method of physical violence. The world is in desperate need of such maladjustments to bring a daybreak of freedom and justice. That's what the whole movement's about. We aren't engaged in any negative protest and in any negative argument with anybody. We are saying that we are determined to be men. We are determined to be people. We are saying that we are God's children and that we don't have to live like we are forced to live. I don't know what will happen now. I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Now we're going to march again, and we've got to march again in order to put issue where it is supposed to be. Let justice roll down like waters and righteousness like a mighty stream. We'll be right back.
all can't kill my free spirit.
We will join the standing up, and the ones who stood without sweet company will sing and sing back into the mountain, and if necessary, even under the sea.